It was all one right after another. I had the hysterectomy, and then 6 weeks later, I had the thyroid removed. During that process, because I had lost some belly fat, I had a lot of excess skin, and my gynecologist happened to do discount tummy tucks. So I said, screw it, let's do it. And I went ahead with the surgery, but it wasn't done correctly. Now it looks like my stomach was chewed up and spit back out. I asked the doctor, so is the swelling down there gonna go down? And she said, you gotta give it 6 more months, another 2 years, and it's still not going down. I also have like little dog ears on the side from where the sutures went, and she said that was normal. So it looks like I got little pita chips on the sides. About 8 to 9 months after the surgery, when I started doing a lot of intensive exercising, I noticed that there was some kind of a discharge coming out of my belly button. It did not smell good, and I was cleaning that sucker every day. I try to avoid situations where I'll be in an enclosed area with people so that nobody else has to endure it, because if I smell it, I know other people smell it. I am 2 years cancer-free now, which is great, but I feel so self-conscious about what I look like. No matter how much weight I lose, this problem isn't going to be fixed. I want to look normal down there again.
What's the overall look? Let's look at this, okay? Okay, well, first of all, I can tell you, you don't have a belly button. Your belly button died.
All this time I've been saying my belly button smells like a dead body, and well, that's because it is actually dead.
So that's problem number one. Problem number two is you have a little of excess loose skin. Problem number three is you have these dog ears. And then of course you have this, the fupa. That is really large. I mean, what did she do? Just look at this and go, well, never mind
that.
Can't
do it, yeah.
My feeling about untrained physicians doing surgery that they have no formal training in is basically, if you're not trained to do an operation, you shouldn't be doing that surgery. That's where problems can occur. If you want to go down this road, we would completely redo this tummy tuck and try to make you a new belly button. It's really questionable whether that can be done.
Will the smell go?
Oh, that smell's gonna go, okay?
It's really important because I can't live with it anymore. I just can't wait till that smell is gone. I'm so hopeful and optimistic, though.
Yeah.
I've never been before. So thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it. The last 3 years have been pretty difficult. You go from being told you need a hysterectomy at 38 to, oh, by the way, you have thyroid cancer now. And then bonus, you also have this botched surgery. I mean, it got really bad there and it got into a very dark place. But today I'm going to meet with my husband and my daughter, Sanaya, and we're gonna go on a scenic bike ride.
It's cool that she wanted to come out here. I'm so excited to see what she looks like.
Me too.
They know I've been working hard, but I haven't been showing them what's going on. And the healing process, I mean, it was long. So I'm really excited to see how they react.
What's up, Slowpoke?
Hey!
Hey! Oh. Okay. Oh my gosh, you look amazing.
Wow.
Right?
My mom looks very beautiful today. I think her stomach looks amazing now, and I'm really happy for her because it's great seeing her in a better mood and being happy and healthy.
You look totally different.
What? See how flat it is now?
Well, you look amazing, babe.
I cannot believe this.
It's totally gone.
When's the last time you saw me in spandex, right?
How do you feel?
I feel great. This is the best thing that's ever happened. I mean, honestly, I thought they'd never be able to fix it.
Before my surgery with Dr. Dubrow, I had a super fupa, a misshapen stomach, and a dead belly button that smelled like death. And now I have a super tight stomach, and I got a cute little coochie, and I have a belly button that's alive and normal looking and doesn't smell.
You look great. I'm jealous. Love you, babe.
Thank you.